everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we're doing something kind of new, as in I'm inching my way into booktube because I wanted to record a reading vlog. I've been wanting to record a reading vlog for a while, and honestly I feel like I'm gonna talk enough as it is, so I'll just move on, like introducing the books that I'm gonna be reading today in this vlog. I only have one right now since the rest are library books and I need to pick them up still, but the one I do have right now is If He Had Been With Me. Obviously this is the Spanish version though, because it's the one that my mom had and it's the only one I have available right now. But I'm hoping to finish this by Tuesday, since Tuesday is when I'm going to go pick up the library books, and it's Saturday, so that's perfectly doable for me. Honestly, I guess I'm supposed to tell you what this book is about. I don't really know though. I guess it's just these two people were together and they're not together anymore, and we're gonna find out what happened for them not to be together anymore. I think they're called Autumn and Finn. So a lot of the times when they'll translate it to Spanish, they'll switch the characters' names and make it have this really weird name in Spanish. But this one, I don't think this one did it, because the names don't feel weird. So they might be Autumn and Finn, or in English, they might be completely different names, but that's what it is here, and we're just gonna get reading. It's the next day and I'm here with a little reading update on this book. So yesterday I actually got to page 104, which is a little after where my mom left off. She left off literally like two pages before. So far not a lot of it's happening. Like, it just feels kind of like slice of life in a way, except I remember people saying that this book like is sad, and I'm obviously not there yet, because not too much is happening. I don't really have a lot of thoughts yet. I do think it's cute though. Their little friendship, Autumn and Finn, that they had. I don't really know why they drifted off. I feel like there's really not much reasoning. They just grew up. And honestly, that makes sense, because a lot of my friendships ended off. We just drifted off. We had no reason to. I do want to add though, they keep shrugging a lot. And I don't know if they did that in the English version of it, but like they struggle. I'm trying to find, let me find it here. It says Sasha se encoge de hombros. It keeps saying that everyone keeps shrugging. Like, I kind of get it though, because whenever people ask me stuff, most of the times I just respond shrugging. I just don't use words, I guess. But we'll see. I'm trying to read to 200 today. I'm probably going to make it. Like, not to brag, but I think I am. And we'll just see how it ends up happening. And I'm in front of this bookshelf that my brother built. Those are like his books. And those are mine. This one and this one I haven't read. Those are literally like the only two books I have in my physical TBR. Because everything else I've read. Oh, and A Little Life too. I haven't read that one either. But I'm not reading them this vlog. We're gonna read them at some other point. Because I want to take my time with them. Hey guys, I'm back with a little reading update, which is not a very good reading update because I decided to not finish reading the book. Here's the thing, right? It's very slow paced already, and I'm reading it in Spanish. I read a lot slower in Spanish than I read in English, and it's bothering me. Which is making me realize if I didn't read that fast in English, I probably wouldn't even enjoy reading as much as I do right now. I enjoy it because I can actually get through books fast when I read in English. I understand Spanish, obviously, or else I wouldn't have gotten that far. But it's just more difficult for me to read in Spanish because I never read in Spanish. And I never read in Spanish because I get so annoyed from how slow I read, which is like, feel like there's a specific term for that. It's like chicken and egg situation. I don't even know, but I'm probably never gonna get better at reading Spanish, so. As you guys saw earlier, I was in the school library and I picked up this book. It's called An Embryo in the Ashes by Saba Tahir. I'm pretty sure I did not pronounce that correctly, but I was thinking of picking it up and then I saw the book and like, it's pretty thick considering I want to finish it before I go pick up the other books from the library. But then I realized maybe I shouldn't be worried because just in school I read 138 pages. So I think we'll be fine. I'm liking this book so far, but it does like mention a lot of like dark things at random points, and I don't know how to feel about them. I definitely don't like that that's happening, but like it's part of the story, you know? It makes the story. Also, I'm checking this book out because I saw this link on Katie is reading her YouTube channel where she was linking it to her Discord where she has the Wyverns and Words book club with Cassandra. I forgot her YouTube name, but like I'll put a picture somewhere of both of them. And I realized that the one for this coming month is the third book in this series, and then I decided on a whim that I'm gonna have to catch up now. So this is the first book called An Embryo in the Ashes, and I think I want to try to get to page 230 today because that's about halfway through the book. I've seen this book. So, well, first of all, I apologize for the lighting. It's gonna be pretty weird because it's nighttime. I didn't have time to record an update earlier, but I did finish An Embryo in the Ashes. And I really, really enjoyed it. I'm still not sure if I would give it a 5-star though, or if it's just a really high 4-star because I really enjoyed it, but there were points that like kind of threw me off, and those points threw me off a lot. So I'm still not sure how to feel, but I really enjoyed, like, I can't really speak much without giving away spoilers, but I really enjoyed their dynamic, kind of. And there is one thing that, like, kind of bothered me at times. It's like, I don't think it's really a spoiler, but this one girl, she's the only girl in the soldier academy that they have there. And there are points where, like, the guys will admire her, kind of, and then she starts showing a little too much emotions, and they'll be like, oh, she's acting like a girl again. And I don't know, that kind of bothered me. I get bothered easily, though, so that's that. But I'm gonna pick up the second book in the series once I finish the books I picked up at the library earlier. Oh, by the way, I did record in Barnes & Noble, but I didn't end up getting anything because I'm broke, and then I went to the library after. So what I did get at the library, I got volume 19, 20, and 21. I just don't have the other two to show you right now. But I already finished volume 19, and I think after I finish these three, I'm gonna take a break from the series because it's starting to feel kind of boring. Like, I don't... Okay, I'm gonna speak my truth. I feel like Yu's character is getting kind of one-dimensional because lately his personality, like, he just seems like he's very much like, he loves his family. Like, I get it. You love your family. What else? He just keeps talking about his family. Okay. And I don't really like that, but the last book I got was The Memory Police by Yoko Ogawa. It's basically about, there's an island, and these people keep forgetting random items that are going missing. So none of them care because they don't remember the items. As I was saying, items are going missing, but no one remembers these items, so they don't really care. And it starts getting serious, and there's one person who remembers it. She's a writer, I believe, and then she realizes somehow that her editor is going to go missing. So now she's trying to hide. And, like, the premise seemed interesting, so I'm gonna try to read this now. I only have this book, so I think before this vlog is over, I'm also going to read the second book in the An Ember in the Ashes series. But that's about it. If I move just a bit, the lighting ends up being horrible. So I don't know how to fix that, but I think, okay, reading update, right? I started reading this yesterday. I got to 112 yesterday, and then today I kept reading it. I'm on 240 right now, and I'm expecting to finish this today. I'm really enjoying it. It's messing with my feelings, but I kind of like that it's messing with my feelings because I feel like I haven't read a book lately that messes with my feelings like that. And I like how it's kind of questioning humanity at points, but it's not too obvious, so it doesn't throw people off. Overall, I really like how the author has written this, and like, it inspires me to write better and keep writing my own stuff. So that I can someday not write exactly like this, but, you know, connect to readers like that. It's just a really good book overall, which is why I was able to read it so fast. Maybe I just don't have a life though, so I can't be sure. But I'm gonna finish that. I got this earlier in my school's library, and I think I'm gonna start reading this tomorrow. So I'm excited for that. I just finished reading this, and there is only like a few words that can fully capture my thoughts without giving spoilers. What did I just read? That's that. Hello guys, again. So I've decided that this is gonna be the last update of the day, right? Of the video. So first of all, I went to the library yesterday and I picked up these two books. I'm not sure if I already told you guys, but I got Lower Memphis Volume 1 and A Torch Against the Night, which is the second book in the series of An Ember in the Ashes, right? I can't see anything right now. I'm nearly done with this one, and it's entertaining. It's not the best, but I'm definitely entertained by it, so I'm going to keep reading it. And I got to page 50 of this book, and I'm very interested already, but I'm not gonna finish it in this vlog because I feel like this vlog might be too long already. If it's not, then honestly ignore this. I'm gonna come back, but if it is, I'm not gonna finish it in this video. Probably gonna finish it over the weekend though, because it's Saturday. And I went to Barnes & Noble earlier, and I got the first book that I bought in this vlog, and the only book that I'm gonna buy in this vlog, which is obviously Once Upon a Broken Heart by Stephanie Garber. I had originally gone in for I Who Have Never Known Men by that person, and it was $17 for a little thin book, and I cannot justify that in my head, no matter how hard I tried, which is sad because the libraries don't have it. So I bought this book, which I've been wanting to get a copy of since I've been seeing it go around, right? And I finally have it, and I'm excited to read it. So that means I now have 4 books in my physical TBR, and I haven't read any of them, but I'm gonna get to it, I promise. I actually promise, though I know a lot of people promise and they don't get to it, but I'm actually gonna get to it, okay? Just have faith in me. But that's everything I wanted to say. Besides that, if I do end the video here, then thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video and that you will come back next time, because next time I think I'm going to record a very specific video. I have been kind of excited to record for a while, so I hope to see you guys again, and I hope you enjoyed this somewhat weird vlog. I really enjoyed the books I read in this vlog. I don't remember what I read. I should probably touch upon what I read again, but honestly, I feel like there's no need. I don't talk all that much, in case you haven't noticed yet. I also took off my glasses because it was glaring in my face, but I'm talking too much. Thank you, and I hope to see you again.